Hello, it's been a while, but I've got something behind the camera that I've got to show everyone, so I'm gonna go get it. It's finally done! Now, I know the last video I made on this was me painting the frame, and then I sort of went radio silent, disappeared, and then now it's all of a sudden it's done. So I will do some explaining. It hasn't just like repaired itself, obviously. Made a couple of mistakes on this bike as well, and made some obvious changes, which I will do a little quick walkthrough first before I do some more explaining about the engine. I'll run some time lapses as well, just so you guys can see like what I've actually done to the bike, apart from the obvious, which is, well, it's turned very yellow now. So for those who are new to the channel or just returning viewers, this is the original MT-07 that I had when I started the channel, and it's been through a lot with me. Great bike when I first had it, did a lot of mods to it. A lot of the mods that are on the bike are still from the original bike when it wasn't crashed yet. So like the O-lins I'd done, the ECU flash I'd done, did the, oh no, brake lines I didn't do actually, and it had a different Akrapovic exhaust. But yeah, since I had some issues with the exhaust, which was pretty obvious when the engine kind of blew itself up, I decided to swap it to like a full-on Akrapovic exhaust instead of just having like a temporary solution, which was the Chinese exhaust I had, which actually ruined the bike. So like I said, I've been through a lot with this bike, had it for 5 years, almost died on it once.
You good?
Then almost died on it again. And then I blew the engine up. So it's been through a lot and it deserves to be fixed and to be ridden again. So I've decided to just like do everything off camera, and I'm not gonna try to make any excuses. I was just being lazy, not filming. See, the biggest change, which I'm really proud to talk about, is this full Akrapovic carbon exhaust. And it sounds great. I still got the baffle in because it's actually really loud, and I forgot how loud this bike is. And then the airbox, completely changed the airbox because I just thought, you know, if I got the engine out, I've always thought the airbox has some restrictions in it. Some people say that you lose power from doing this. I'm not so sure about that, maybe, but I can always go for a dyno tune to see if, well, depends on what power I get. If it's substantially lower, then yeah, if it's not good for performance, I'll just put the old airbox back in. If it's negligible, I'd rather just keep it in just so I can have better sound on it. And then obviously the other downside is that I can't actually ride in the rain with this anymore because water will get in. So I'm gonna do some CAD work, see if I can design like a panel to fit around here as like a splash cover. So now onto the elephant in the room, and the whole reason why I started this whole project was because of the engine.
I had some footage that was filmed a while back of me taking the engine apart, so I'll just do a little voiceover over the footage. So at this point, I'd already set the engine top dead center, removed the cam cover and the cams. So now I'm just removing the spark plugs and the bolts that hold the valve head down so I could remove the valve head in order to see the pistons. I was expecting to see damaged cylinder walls or cracked piston rings, but I'll get onto removing the pistons in a bit. This is when I started making mistakes, because I drained the oil out so I could remove the alternator cover, clutch cover and the sump cover. At the time, I didn't know, I just had to remove the sump cover to get access to the bottom of the pistons, where they were connected to the crankshaft. I then removed the pistons to find out there was actually nothing wrong with them at all, and the ring gaps were actually in spec as well. So the next step was to check if there was any leaking in the valves, which there weren't. I decided to remove all the valves, and I actually managed to find the issue here. There was like a shim lodged in the shim seat. After looking at it more closely, I found that 3 of the 4 exhaust valve shim seats actually had cracks or scratches in them, so the valve shims wouldn't be able to sit in them properly. I later did the clearances off camera and found that all the exhaust valves had 0 clearance, which explains why the loss of compression. So here's just me using a valve spring compressor tool to compress the springs down so it doesn't shoot off through the like, ceiling of the workshop. and then getting the valves out, putting them into a drill bit or a drill chuck, and then if you spin the drill as you're looking down the barrel of it, you can see if there's any deviation. And everything was fine. The valves were straight. There was no problem with the valve seat areas or the valve seats. So I just put everything back together with new shim seats. And I guess the rest was explained in the beginning of the video. So all caught up.
I know this video is long overdue, but I'm just kind of glad that I've managed to finish this bike. We've still got a couple of things that I need to do on the bike in the future. But that will just be some more videos to come. But yeah, I'm just glad that I can get to ride my original MT-07 again. But yeah, thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it was a lot of talking. Hopefully in the next couple of videos, there'll be more doing instead of talking. So yeah, until next time, see you guys.